At its simplest, texturing works as follows. You take some location on a surface. Given that location, use some function to change the surface attributes at that location. For example, you could change the color, shininess, transparency, normal, or even the surface height or shape. That's all there is to it. What the lessons ahead will cover is what sorts of functions are used and some of the popular ways to modify the surface. Let's take a concrete example. Well, maybe not concrete. Let's make it wood. In fact, let's make it the most popular object in video gaming, the crate. I looked it up. One site claims there are 740-odd video games with crates in them, and counting. You have some object, such as a box. You'd like to make it look like a crate. The most common way to apply a texture to a surface is to use an image and glue it on, sort of like wallpaper. What you'd like to get out is this, the crate texture applied to the box. In 3JS, this is amazingly simple. Here's the code snippet that does it. The first line loads the texture. The second line applies this texture to a material. Done! Maybe I should just wrap up this unit with that. For this simple case, everything just worked. 3JS has a reasonable default for applying a square texture to square box sides. That said, I should give you fair warning about loading textures. There are security concerns enforced with WebGL. The short version is that you can't normally load some texture from another site into your program. Your program and the texture need to be in the same local space in order to run. See the additional course materials for more information.